Thank you. Yeah, so I'm not going to take a long time over this. We had a big survey with a lot of results, obviously. Sorry. It's okay, I don't need to move anymore. Okay. That's it. and yeah, so you've got in your packs the short, very short version of the results of our survey of our partners. We also had a big meeting yesterday, which we've not documented yet, but that was adding to the survey we started out with. And we do this process every 2 years because the European Rural Parliament is a movable feast. We're not static. Things can evolve and change, and we want them to. We don't want to stay the same. And we began the whole process in 2013 to open a door, which Staffan Bond did for us in Brussels. And then we've evolved it in the two succeeding rural parliaments, and this time we are looking again now and into the next weeks about where we go from here. And it's very, very important that all the people are partners, but also others out there in the community who would like to see us doing things are able to contribute to that thinking process. We're coming to the end of a two-year funding period as of January next year. And then we have to rethink our plans and we have to rethink our next rural parliament, and there'll be a lot of issues surrounding that. So this is the moment in the year when we begin to plan. So just looking a little bit at the survey that we carried out, some of the ideas that have been raised and which can be discussed in this session in a minute. We asked people what they thought the main achievements of the ERP were, and it's not just this event, it's the whole of the ERP as an initiative. And not surprisingly, maybe, this gathering and our manifesto were rated as the most important achievements. But also the building of this ERP partnership, which now has 40 countries, maybe 41, and also 6 pan-European rural networks as partners, was seen as a big achievement. And helping through that to articulate the rural voice from all of these 40 countries. Also that we have visibility and that we do appear at meetings in the European Union and Commission, and that we're known about there and I think respected in the key DGs that we relate to. And also that we have been involved in helping to promote and connect rural parliaments, and Goran's book is a very fine example of one of the ways that we've been doing that. We asked people about what their priorities for the future should be with the ERP, and these seem to be advocacy, because, you know, this is the hard thing for people to do from a national level. And we have an opportunity as a platform, as a voice, to promote advocacy at the European level. And networking, of course, which is what we do probably better than anything, actually. So enabling partners to share information and experience. But these two things were seen very much as being linked. You cannot do advocacy without having done the networking first, so that you know what you're advocating about. And this event, of course, is our biggest networking event, but we do things in between times as well. In terms of how people see the ERP going forward, the majority saw it as carrying on as an ongoing informal network and process, which supports partnership and advocacy, a kind of flexible umbrella to reinforce and support the work of its partners, and that the individual organizations that are involved, the 3 co-initiating organizations and others, are seen as an important part of implementing this, you know, that the ERP as an umbrella isn't necessarily the vehicle that's implementing everything. In terms of how we are organized, an informal network, undertaking networking, advocacy, thematic work around key themes that people identify, we asked people if they would be prepared to get involved in helping and doing things, and quite a lot of organizations said they're ready to help in terms of co-organizing events or inviting us to events or vice versa. Three countries actually said they were interested in hosting the next ERP, which is a good thing, the 5th ERP. So we're always looking for people wanting to do that because it's a very big responsibility. thematic events working with the themes we're identifying now in this Rural Parliament and the ones that come up as being priorities into the future. But we must not be seen to be replacing the activities of our partners. I think we're not competing with our partners, but we are acting to support them in the ways that they wish us to do that. So in terms of active participation, yes, partners want to be actively involved, but they need clarity about roles and responsibilities. Also, their involvement must benefit their own agendas. It's not something that they have time to do in addition to the things that they already have prioritised. People wanted to see us more active in Eastern Europe and in non-EU countries, which might include Britain in the future. And in terms of thematic work, youth, sustainable development, environment, local self-government, education, etc., were all seen as core priorities for looking at thematic work. We asked people a little bit about how we communicate with them, and this is always an issue for us. You know, we've tried lots of different ways of communicating. We email you all, and maybe people do or don't read those emails. We have a website, and I don't know how many people actively use our website. There's a lot of information on it. We have a newsletter, which I think more people do pick up and probably use. We have Facebook, which I think quite a lot of people do log on to. But the thing is that this communication has to be two-way. And I think we also feel that sometimes it's a little bit one-way. You know, we're sending things out to you, and sometimes it feels like it's going out into outer space because we're not quite sure what your reactions were or if you even looked at it. And we need you to feed back to us because you are the organisation, you are the partners, not us, not the steering group. So we absolutely have to have your communication to us as well as our communications to you. So those were the main things, I think, on which we can base some discussion now. We talked yesterday, and, you know, I think over to Goran now to facilitate a discussion.